physics class once again, class 7. So today we are going to discuss some of the exercise for revision questions of page number 17 and 18. Okay, so please take out your book and we'll start it. Okay, now here there are some of the tick the correct options. Look at the number 1. Which of the following is the incorrect relation? Number option A, here I'm going to use the board for your convenience. Option A is given as D equals to M by V. B is given V equals to M by D. C as M equals to D into V. And D as D equals to V by M. Now among all these 4, which is the wrong answer? Okay, we have to find out. So if you recall, density equals to mass per volume, right? Now we will tally which are the right options. Now this is right, got it? Now if when we have to find out the volume, we are just going to cross multiply. So here V will go up and D will come down in its position. So when we are finding out volume, this is also a right option. Again, when we need to find the mass, okay, when we need to find the mass, V is going up out there, and so it will be D into V. So here option D, that is D equals to V by M, that is not possible. So this is going to be the option D. Okay. So now coming to the number 2, the SI unit of density is, we all know that SI unit of density is kg per meter cube, right? After that, let's move to the next one. Now look at the number 3. The density of a ball is 19.3 gram per centimeter cube. Okay, so density of a ball is written as 19.3 gram per centimeter cube, right? Again, what has been asked, what is its density in kilogram kg per meter cube? So we have to convert this into its kg per meter cube. Now we have already known one relation, right? 1 gram per centimeter cube is equals to 1000 kg per meter cube, right? So if 19.3 gram per centimeter cube it is, then how much it will be when we are converting it to kg per meter cube? So 19.3 multiplied with 1000, so how much it will be? Multiply it and we are getting a number of 19300. Okay, so this much will be 19300 kg per meter cube. All right, now after that there is a question number 4. The density of iron is density of, okay, this was number 3. Coming back to number 4, here density of iron is equals to 7.8 gram per centimeter cube. Once again, density of zinc is 7.15 gram per centimeter cube. Okay, now they have said that for the same mass, so if D is equals to M by V, mass will remain constant. Okay, so mass will remain constant, that means same mass. The volume of A, zinc is more than iron, B, iron is more than zinc, C, both iron and zinc is same, nothing can be said. So last two options, C and D, will be nullified. It is not possible, because according to the relation, when the mass is constant, that will vary. Okay, so here among these first two, that will be one. Now what will be the right option, how we are going to determine? So in case of iron, density is 7.8, right, where the mass is constant and volume is variable. Again, in case of zinc, 7.15 it is, and mass is constant once again, and volume is variable. Now, say mass is constant, so we are not going to consider it. Now, if the volume we are getting it out here, if the volume is, we have to find out the volume. Now, volume will go up as according to the relation, and density will come down as the denominator. Now, when we are finding like that, so here according to that, it will be mass by 7.8, and once again here mass is the constant and it will be 7.15. Now, there is a shortcut method, as we have already known this, that whoever is having a bigger denominator, that is having basically the smaller number, right? So the when the density of the iron is 7.8, so the volume is basically smaller or bigger. Try it out, whether the density or volume will be bigger or smaller. So the correct option will be number A, zinc is more than iron, because here see, when we are determining the volume for zinc, the denominator is smaller in case of zinc while that of in iron. Understand? So the volume of the zinc will be higher. Understand? I hope you understand this. Let's make it once more, that when the volume is bigger, density will be smaller. When the density will be bigger, volume will be smaller. Understand the relation? Okay. Now coming to the next one. Number 5. The cube of copper having density 8.9 gram per centimeter cube has a volume of 25 centimeter cube. So the mass of the cube will be, there are options given. Okay, so here for the number 5, see, the density of the copper cube is given as 8.9 gram per centimeter cube. Once again, the volume is given as 25 centimeter cube. Okay, both are having in the same unit. So how we are going to determine the mass? We know that the relation D equals to M by V, or M is equals to D into V, right? So D into V stands for 8.9 into 25. So after multiplying this two, what we are going to get? We are going to get a number of 222.5 gram. So the mass will be, this is the mass of the copper. Okay, so the correct option will be option number B. Okay. So after that, there is a true and false. First one is saying equal mass of different substance have same volume. Now you remember the activity we have done in our earlier class, where it says that equal mass, though we are having equal mass of salt and iron, volume is varying. So it is a wrong one. That means equal mass of different substance does not always have equal or same volume. Okay, they can have different volume. So this is a false one. Number 2, equal volume of different substance have different mass. Remember it, the activity or with having four blocks, similar volume means 1 cc volume with different masses. So that is a true option. Number 3, when more amount of mass is packed within same volume, it becomes lighter. No, it does not. So it's a false one. Number 4, density of a substance increases when the mass of a substance is increased for a given volume. Yes. So when the mass is increased, density of the substance will increase eventually because of the relation. See, when the mass is increasing, density is increasing. Whereas when the volume is decreasing, density will increase. Got it? So number 5, density of a substance increases when the volume is increased for a given mass. according to this relation, that will be a false statement as well. Okay, so these are some of the questions we have discussed out here, which are related to all of the topics we have studied till date, and we are going to pass on to the next topic in our next class. So thank you for watching.